Hi, hello everyone. Can someone tell me if I am audible and visible both? Hi Sandeep, hi Enam, hi Sunil Kumar. Just give me a thumbs up if you think I am audible and visible. The topic that we have selected today are must know images in sexually transmitted diseases. Okay? Yeah. So to introduce myself, I am Dr. Resham Vasani. I am a consultant dermatologist at Matunga in Mumbai, and I'm also associated with the Nauroji Wadia and the BJ Wadia Hospital for Children. And I have been an assistant professor at KJ Somaiah Medical College for 10 years, and now I am with an academy. So, with that introduction, I would like you to know about the plus subscription of an academy. So, the plus subscription of an academy is where you get the best, I'm sorry. Through the plus subscription, you get access to the live classes, the structured courses, the unlimited access to all the lectures of an academy. And you also have the iconic subscription. So through the iconic subscription, it's like a combo offer of both an academy as well as prep ladder. So through the an academy, you get your live classes and batch courses, live tests and quizzes. While through prep ladder, you have video lectures and question bank as well as rapid revision courses. You should also be aware that there are daily free test series, okay, on an academy NEET PG for the upcoming exams. So there is a test series for NEET PG T20, okay, which is at 8 p.m. every day. Then there is a test series for FMGE, which is targeted towards 2021 FMGE, this year's FMGE, which is at 8:30. Then we have NEET PG 2022 test series, which happens at 9 p.m. and INICET daily. For 2021, which happens also at 9 p.m. So it will be a question series of 20, which you have to solve in the next 20 minutes. Also, there is something called as an academy combat. So Sunil says, I am weak in English. I can't understand easily running voice. Okay, no problem. I'll try to be as slow as possible and I will try and mix Hindi, okay, so it's easier for you to understand. So we have another course which is an academy combat, okay, which is targeted towards NEET PG, okay. So it will be a series of 45 super questions which are curated to match the latest exam trends. So it will be a 60-minute session of brain-stimulating experience, and there will be detailed video solutions as well by the India's best educators. It is completely free, and if you do win this combat, then you have a chance to win free an Academy Plus subscriptions as well as Amazon vouchers. The next combat goes live on January 24 at 5 p.m. So make sure you do attend this, okay? And definitely you have a great chance of winning some great goodies. Also, there are certain upcoming batches for the NEET PG exam. Well, New Concept has asked me whether an academy can start nursing coaching. Well, I am not the right person to opine on that, but I think I will get across this to the people concerned and they will be able to answer you better. Okay, so there are these upcoming batches for NEET PG exams. Okay, ये start हो रहे हैं 14 जनवरी 2021. एक batch है जो FMGE students के लिए targeted है. दूसरी batch evening batch है जो 15 जैन से शुरू हो रही है. And there is another batch which is starting as a morning batch on 18th of January. आप ये सारे जो batches हैं उसे आप subscribe कर सकते हो, और जब भी आप subscribe करोगे तब आपको code use करना है mentor, MENTOR. ये code use करने पर आपको additional 10% you know you'll get a leeway on that. सो फॉर दैट वॉट यू नीड टू डू, आपको अनअकैडमी लर्निंग ऐप डाउनलोड करना है जो आपके iOS और एंड्रॉयड प्लेटफॉर्म्स पे अवेलेबल है. ओके, एंड दीज आर द प्राइसिंग, दिस इज द प्राइसिंग. सो इफ यू आर, सो वेन यू आर यूजिंग अ, वेन यू आर टारगेटिंग अ प्लस सब्सक्रिप्शन ऑफ नीट पीजी, इफ यू आर गोइंग इन फॉर अ 12 month सब्सक्रिप्शन, इट विल कॉस्ट यू अराउंड 2063 अ मंथ. While for the NEET PG subscription, it will cost you around 4,125 a month. So it's iconic. If an iconic is basically an academy with prep ladder, and plus is just an academy. Okay. So for either of these, whenever you do subscribe, do use the code mentor. Okay. And when you use a code mentor, you will get a 10% additional 10% off. Now let's go to our sexually transmitted diseases. Sunil, I am not the right person to decide when will the nursing coaching start, but definitely once I come to know, I will let you know. Okay, so let's begin. We have a 24-year-old male who presents with a single painless ulcer on the external genitalia, as you can see in the picture. The choice of laboratory test to look out for the etiological agent would be scraping from the ulcer for culture on chocolate agar with chocolate supplement, serology for detection of specific IgM antibodies, scrapings from ulcer for dark field microscopy, or scrapings for ulcer for tissue culture. Right? So, what do you think is the correct answer? So, new concept says it's D, culture. Amit Dhama says it's C. First of all, tell me, what do you think is the diagnosis looking at the picture? To elaborate on this picture, I would say that this is a solitary, okay, it is a solitary, okay, I can see that there is a solitary ulcer. It's a clean looking ulcer, okay, it's not a dirty looking ulcer, there's no slough over it, it's a clean looking ulcer, and as you can see that it's quite well defined, okay, and this ulcer is having an indurated base. Right, so all this description is extremely important. At the end of it, what do you think is the answer? Yes, Amit, you are completely correct. We are dealing with a patient having primary syphilis or syphilitic chancre. Okay, so in the stage of primary syphilis, when you have the syphilitic chancre, the best investigation that you can do to look out for the etiological agent which you most likely is Treponema pallidum, right? So to demonstrate Treponema pallidum, because it's a very, very thin, fragile kind of an organism, you need to do a contrast microscopy. So you'll have to go in for a dark field microscopy. So you can take a scraping from the ulcer and subject it to dark field microscopy to look out for the organism. Right. So now let's revise syphilis. Syphilis is, as you know, caused by Treponema pallidum. There are multiple troponemes, okay, which are present in the oral cavity. They are also, yes, new concept. For syphilis, we do the VDRL test. But for VDRL, the patient has to be in the secondary stage of syphilis. Okay, at this stage, when we are doing in the primary syphilis stage, okay, the most appropriate test to demonstrate the organism, read the question carefully, they have mentioned the choice of laboratory test to look out for the etiological agent. Okay, so the choice of lab test to look out for the etiological agent will be a scraping from ulcer for dark field microscopy. VDRL, you may not get positive at this stage, okay, because it's an antibody test. For the antibodies to form, it would take around 3 to 6 weeks, right? So at this stage of a primary chancre, the best test to do is to do a scraping from a ulcer for the dark field microscopy. Okay, VDRL is definitely the test of choice when we are dealing with secondary syphilis. Okay, I hope that's clear, new concept. So to revise syphilis, syphilis is caused by Treponema pallidum. Okay, now there are multiple troponemes which are situated in the oral cavity, they are situated in the perianal area. Okay, and it is important for you to differentiate between the Treponema pallidum, which is pathogenic, versus the commensal troponemes. Okay, for that you need to look out for the classical mobility. So in the classical motility, if you see that there is rotation on its long axis, classical bending corkscrew motility, twisting from side to side, then it is suggesting that you are dealing with Treponema pallidum, which is a pathogenic organism for syphilis. Okay, so syphilis has multiple stages. The first stage is the primary stage, okay, in which you get the classical Hunterian chancre, also called as the heart chancre of syphilis. The incubation period of syphilis is between 9 to 90 days. Okay, so the classical chancre is a solitary, painless, please remember it's painless, painless lymphadenopathy, painless ulcer in syphilis. Okay, so it's a solitary painless ulcer with regular edges. It is a clean looking ulcer. Okay, means there is hardly any slough at the base. You don't see any pus discharge, nothing. It's a clean looking ulcer with an indurated base. Indurated means the base is thickened. Okay, if you feel the base, you will feel that the base is thickened, it's hard. Okay, so it has a button like consistency or a cartilage feel. Okay, so this, if you see, if you feel your tip of the nose, okay, that is the consistency which you will feel at the base of the chancre. Chancre means a sore. Sahaji, chancre means a sore. Okay, sore means an ulcer. Okay, so hard chancre means the base of this ulcer is, the base of this ulcer is indurated. Triphilix asks me what is the meaning of the Dory flap sign. So Dory flap sign says that if you have an ulcer, okay, on the preputial skin, on the inner aspect of the preputial skin, then when you try and retract the preputial skin, this particular ulcer will flip back, okay, to its normal position. So that is called as the Dory flap sign. Dory flap sign occurs because the base of that ulcer is hard. Okay, so it is not possible for you to retract the prepuce. The prepuce is going to come back to its original position. So that is called as the Dory flap sign. Remember, in chancre, in syphilis, the lymphadenopathy is also painless. So in addition to the ulcer being painless, you have painless lymphadenopathy, which is going to be unilateral or bilateral, and it has a typical shotty or a rubbery feel. Okay, so remember everything about a chancre, it's very, very important. Remember the features like solitary, painless, clean looking, indurated base, cartilage feel, painless, unilateral or bilateral, shotty lymph nodes. Triphilix, let me explain to you. It is not painful in lymphogranuloma venereum. The ulcer in lymphogranuloma venereum is transient, it is painless, and it goes unnoticed in lymphogranuloma venereum. In lymphadenopathy, yes, lymphadenopathy in LGV can be painful, okay, and there can be what is described as a bubo. Bubo is a painful lymph node enlargement which usually occurs in the inguinal region. Right, so LGV lymphadenopathy is painful, but so is in chancroid. So if you compare chancre with chancroid, chancroid is caused by Kallimatobacterium granulomatis. Okay, so when you compare it with chancroid, in chancroid there can be multiple ulcers in contrast to solitary ulcer of syphilis. Okay, in addition, remember that ulcers of chancroid, they are dirty looking versus the clean looking ulcers of primary syphilis. Then if you see the base of the primary syphilitic chancre, it's indurated, while that in case of a chancroid, it is, yes, in a chancroid it is very soft. So that is why it's called as a soft sore, also called as a soft chancre. Okay, yes, Triphilix, you are right that multiple ulcers are also seen in HSV, but in HSV the early lesion, the first lesion that you will be able to see is a vesicle. So there will be multiple vesicles which are grouped together. Okay, that's very classical for HSV. There are multiple vesicular lesions which are grouped together, and then they erode, and when they erode, they form multiple ulcers or erosion. They are more likely erosions and not ulcers. What is the difference between erosion and ulcer? Erosion is going to limit itself to the breach in the continuity of the epidermis. While in ulcers, you have the deeper dermis, you have the sometimes the subcutaneous tissue also can get involved. Okay, so there are multiple ulcers with polycyclic margins which are grouped in fashion which you see in herpes simplex virus infections. Okay, so I hope that's clear. So we have seen four ulcers. We have seen chancroidal chancre, that is the primary chancre, which was solitary, painless, clean looking with an indurated base. We have seen chancroid, where there can be multiple or solitary, painful, dirty looking ulcers with non-indurated or soft base. And in cases of chancroid, you have a painful inguinal lymphadenopathy. Okay, so it's an inflammatory bubo in cases of chancroid versus a painless unilateral or bilateral rubbery and shorty consistency of the lymphadenopathy which you see in chancre. So also we have seen LGV. In LGV, we discussed that there is a transient painless ulcer, okay, which may go unnoticed by the patient, and later on when the patient presents to you, he is already in the inguinal stage. So in the inguinal stage, it's characterized by lymphadenopathy, which is very classically called as a bubo, which is a lymph node enlargement. Now in LGV, the lymph nodes can be very painful. There can be involvement of the lymph nodes above and below the inguinal ligament, and therefore you see a groove which is separating the lymph node enlargement above and below the inguinal ligament, which is called as the groove sign. This is again a very important MCQ. Remember, groove sign is seen in lymphogranuloma venerum. Okay, now what happens if you don't treat your chancre? If you don't treat chancre, it will heal in around 1 to 4 months. And remember, the most common site, extra genital site, okay, genital is of course the most common site for a chancre, but the most common extra genital chancre site is the lip, okay. And remember that for the diagnosis of LGV, for the diagnosis of a chancre, what you need to do is to demonstrate the organism. And for demonstrating the organism, what you need to do is either you can take a smear from the ulcer, okay, and the smear from the ulcer you can subject it to dark ground illumination, through which you can diagnose it, or you can aspirate the lymph node, and that aspirate you can subject to the dark ground illumination. Now suppose, as I mentioned, if you are not going to treat chancre, then it will progress to the stage of secondary syphilis. So in the stage of secondary syphilis, there is hematogenous dissemination of the spirochetes if the primary stage is not treated. So what do you have in secondary syphilis? You have a rash, you have condyloma lata, okay, and then you have generalized lymphadenopathy as well as mucus patches. The rash is the most common feature. So if they ask you which is the most common feature of secondary syphilis, it is the rash. Okay, but this rash can be anything under the sun. It can be a papule, it can be a macule, it can be a nodule, it can be a plaque, it can be annular in fashion, it can be scaly, it can be non-scaly, it can be sometimes it can be lichenoid in nature, it can be erythema multiforme. Like, there can be multiple morphologies in secondary syphilis, but what you don't see is vesicles. So remember, vesicular lesions are not seen in secondary syphilis. Palms and soles are classically involved in secondary syphilis. So this is the involvement showing you in macular papular lesions which are seen on the palms and soles in secondary syphilis. This is a very, very important image. Please remember, it can come to you as an image-based MCQ. And remember that if I touch these lesions, okay, if I am pressing these lesions, the patient is going to wince. Okay, so that is called as the deep dermal tenderness. Okay, so deep dermal tenderness is called as the Ollendorf sign. Okay, it's called as the Ollendorf sign, which is seen in secondary syphilis. So remember, Ollendorf sign is seen in secondary syphilis. Yes, सेकेंडरी सिफिलिस इज वन ऑफ द कंडीशंस वेर यू हैव सेंट्रीफ्यूगल स्प्रेड, सो यू हैव मोर लोकलाइजेशन ऑफ द लीजन्स ऑन टू द पाम्स एंड सोल्स. येस, न्यू कंसेप्ट, यू आर राइट. एनी अदर कंडीशन कैन यू टेल मी न्यू कंसेप्ट वेर यू हैव मोर लीजन्स ओवर द एक्रल एरियाज? एनी वायरल एग्जांथम दैट यू आर अवेयर ऑफ विच इज इन्वॉल्विंग द पाम्स एंड सोल्स, हैंड एंड फीट? एनी वायरल एग्जांथम? सेंट्रीफ्यूगल स्प्रेड where there is more localization of lesions on the palms and the soles. Anything? Come on, think. Triphalanx, we don't see smallpox because it's eradicated. Okay, you see it involvement of the face and the trunk, you are right, in smallpox. But remember, hand-foot-mouth disease, as the word suggests, hand-foot-mouth disease, yes, is caused by coccidiosis A16, enterovirus 71, coccidiosis A9, and this condition does manifest as vesicles, and they are typically localized onto the palms and the soles. Okay. In addition, there can be involvement of the mouth, there can be involvement of the buttocks, knees, and the elbows as well. Okay. So remember, among the conditions which are centrifugally spread, where the most concentration of the lesions is on the palms and soles, also includes hand and foot mouth disease. Right. So, remember that now here in cases of secondary syphilis, as we discussed earlier, if I want to diagnose secondary syphilis, I will do just one test. Okay. And that is VDRL. It is 100% sensitive in these cases because here the organism is already hematogeneously disseminated. So the patient can also have the spirochetes which can be cultured from the CNS. Okay, and there is systemic involvement in the phase of secondary syphilis where there can be gastritis, hepatitis, glomerulonephritis, proteinuria, acute meningitis and uveitis. Okay, now let's go to the next question. Name this lesion found in secondary syphilis. Is it a mucus patch, roseola of syphilis, condyloma lata or gamma? So, can someone tell me what is manifesting in the picture? As you can see, they are pink, okay? They are flat and they are moist lesions. Yes, triple helix and amidhama, both of you are right. New concept, you are also right. What we are dealing with is nothing but condyloma lata. Now, what is lata? Lata means flat. What is the meaning of the word condyloma? Condyloma means, what is condyloma? Condyloma means knuckle. Okay, so flat means lata. As you can see in these lesions are most of the times in the perianal areas, in the groins. Okay, so they are seen as classically, they are pink, they are moist, and they are flat lesions. Okay, which happen in the folds of the skin. Okay, and they, remember, they are all teeming with spirochetes. Okay, so they are going to be extremely infectious. So if I take a smear from this and I subject it to DGI, I'm going to get that finding positive because there is a lot of spirochete load in this area. Okay, so do not confuse it with condyloma acuminata. Can somebody tell me what is condyloma acuminata? Yes, condyloma lata, new concept, is also called as condyloma latum. Yes. Yes, Amit and triple helix, both of you are right. Condyloma acuminata is nothing but an HPV infection. So what is acuminata? Acuminate, the word acuminate means pointed. Okay, it means pointed, and lata means flat. So if you see in HPV infections, the lesions, they are usually verrucous, and if you see the tip of the lesion, it's usually pointed. Okay, so they are also pink, they also can be moist, but they are having pointed verrucous kind of an appearance. Okay, so that is why it's called as condyloma acuminata. It is an HPV infection, that is human papilloma virus infection. Most of the times it is HPV 6 and 11. Very good, triple helix, you are right. ओके सो कॉन्डाइलोमा लाटा आर फ्लैट कॉलीफ्लावर लाइक मासेस ऑन द मॉइस्ट स्किन लाइक द एनस ग्रोइन एटसेट्रा दे आर मॉइस्ट इन अपियरेंस एंड दे आर टीमिंग विद स्पाइरोकीट्स. नाउ आइडेंटिफाई द डर्मेटोलॉजिकल कोरिलेट. द पिक्चर दैट आई हैव शोन यू, ओके द पिक्चर दैट आई हैव शोन यू हियर इज नथिंग बट द स्नेल ट्रैक. So, what in syphilis is described as snail track? Can anybody tell me? What in syphilis is described as a snail track? Yes, Amit, you are very right. Snail track ulcers. They are classically described in secondary syphilis. Okay, they are the classical mucosal lesions of secondary syphilis, and remember, even these lesions, they are extremely infectious. Okay, so snail track ulcers, look at this classical picture. You can see this classical picture. The snail track ulcer are the mucous membrane lesions of secondary syphilis, and they are moist and they are extremely infectious. Okay. Now, this is another mucosal lesion of secondary syphilis. These are basically papules. Yes, new concept. They are painless lesions on the mucous membranes which are having a serpiginous appearance or a snail track appearance, and they are extremely infectious. Now, this is another mucosal lesion which is seen in secondary syphilis, and they are called as split papule. So, it's like a papule, but it is at the angle of the mouth. So, it becomes split. Okay, so you can see a lot of maceration, you can see the moist nature of the lesions, right? So split papules are seen in secondary syphilis at the angles of the mouth. Now again, you have to identify the dermatological correlate in this patient, image. What in dermatology mimics this appearance? What in syphilis mimics this appearance? So basically, this is a leaf which has been eaten by a moth. Okay, so moth eaten appearance. What in syphilis gives you a moth eaten appearance? Yes, triple helix, you are right. Yes, you are very correct. Triple helix, moth eaten appearance or moth eaten alopecia is seen in secondary syphilis. Okay, so this is what it looks like. Moth eaten alopecia seen in secondary syphilis. So what are you seeing in secondary syphilis? In secondary syphilis, you see a rash which can be any morphology except there are vesicles, except there are no vesicles. Second, remember that most of the times the rash of secondary syphilis is going to be non-pruritic. Okay, there will be no itching. Okay, there are a few variants which can be itchy, like for example the follicular variant and the lichenoid variant. Okay, of syphilis, which is going to be kind of pruritic. Otherwise, essentially secondary syphilis is a non-pruritic condition. You will see snail track ulcers, you will see condyloma lata, and you are going to see moth-eaten alopecia. Now, triple helix, isko telogen effluvium se kaise differentiate karenge? Dekhiye, telogen effluvium mein kya hota hai? You see, there is generalized hair loss. ठीक है, तो इसमें आपको पैचेस में, जैसे आप देख रहे हो यहाँ पे पैचेस में हेयर लॉस हो रहा है, राइट? तो टीलोजन एफ्लुवियम में जनरलाइज्ड हेयर लॉस होता है, पैचेस में हेयर लॉस नहीं होता. ओके, सो दैट इज वन थिंग व्हाई यू कैन डिफरेंशिएट द टू. ऑल्सो मॉथ ईटन एलोपेशिया, ओनली मॉथ ईटन एलोपेशिया यू कैन नॉट डायग्नोज इट एज सिफिलिस. आपको पूरा हिस्ट्री जानना है, आपको क्लिनिकल एग्जामिनेशन करना है, आपको जेनिटल एग्जामिनेशन करना है, यू हैव टू लुक फॉर द लिम्फ नोड्स. ओके, तो यू विल बी एबल टू कम टू अ कंक्लूसिव डायग्नोसिस दैट यू आर डीलिंग विद मॉथ ईटन एलोपेशिया ऑफ सेकेंडरी सिफिलिस. ऑल्सो ट्राइकोटिलोमेनिया में ऐसे पैचेज में हेयर लॉस नहीं होता. क्या होता है, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल ट्राइकोटिलोमेनिया में यू नो दैट द पेशेंट इज गोइंग टू पुल आउट हिज और हर ओन हेयर, सो इट विल बी ऑन समथिंग विच इज एक्सेसिबल, राइट? सो द पेशेंट इज गोइंग टू मेनली हैव अ पैच ऑफ और मल्टीपल पैचेज ऑफ एलोपेशिया विच विल नॉट बी दिस स्मॉल, दे आर गोइंग टू बी लार्जर पैचेज. ओके, एंड यू विल सी दैट it will be at a site on the scalp which is more accessible to pulling, ठीक है। दूसरी बात क्या होती है दैट इन केसेस ऑफ ट्राइकोटिलोमेनिया बिकॉज द पेशेंट इज पुलिंग आउट द हेयर देन देर इज फ्रैक्चर ऑफ द हेयर शाफ्ट बिकॉज ऑफ दैट ट्रैक्शन यू आर गोइंग टू सी द हेयर विच आर ब्रोकन ऑफ एट डिफरेंट डिफरेंट लेंथ्स ओके। बट इन केसेस ऑफ मोथेटन एलोपेशिया आपको वो पैच में सारे बाल निकल गए होंगे ओके। सो इट्स नॉट दैट द हेयर आर ब्रोकन ऑफ, योर द हेयर आर रिमूव्ड एट द सर्फेस बिकॉज ऑफ द इन्फ्लमेशन इन दैट पर्टिकुलर साइट बिकॉज ऑफ द सिफिलिस ओके। सो दैट्स हाउ यू डिफरेंशिएट। मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम्स देर इज नो प्रॉब्लम ओके। और आपको जब भी क्वेश्चन पूछेंगे एग्जाम में, दे आर गोइंग टू गिव यू अ क्लिनिकल सिनेरियो एंड दे आर गोइंग टू गिव यू अ वेरी टिपिकल पिक्चर, ठीक है। सो दे वोंट जस्ट शो यू दिस पिक्चर एंड आस्क यू वेदर इट सिफिलिस और नॉट, दे आर गोइंग टू गिव यू एन एंटायर हिस्ट्री। सो यू हैव टू रीड द क्वेश्चन केयरफुली, एनालाइज, लुक एट द पिक्चर एंड देन कम टू अ डायग्नोसिस ओके। सो आई थिंक दैट्स द टाइम वी हैव न्यू कंसेप्ट। मिनोक्सिडिल इज द ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस इन विच एलोपेशिया? मिनोक्सिडिल इज द ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस इन एंड्रोजेनेटिक एलोपेशिया। सो व्हेन आई एम डीलिंग विद मेल पैटर्न बॉल्डनेस और व्हेन आई एम डीलिंग विद फीमेल पैटर्न बॉल्डनेस, येस आई विल यूज मिनोक्सिडिल एज माई फर्स्ट लाइन ऑफ ट्रीटमेंट, राइट। बट व्हेन आई एम डीलिंग विद ट्राइकोटिलोमेनिया, व्हेन आई एम डीलिंग विद से साइकेट्रिशल एलोपेशियाज ओके। सो एलोपेशिया इज अ वेरी जनरल टर्म, इट्स लाइक फीवर ओके। यू नीड टू हैव अ कॉज फॉर फीवर, राइट। सो फॉर हेयर लॉस देर आर मल्टीपल कॉजेज एंड मिनोक्सिडिल इज द ड्रग विच वी यूज फॉर एंड्रोजेनेटिक एलोपेशिया, राइट। सो दैट्स द टाइम वी हैव टूडे। थैंक यू एवरी वन फॉर बींग वेरी एक्टिवली पार्टिसिपेटिंग एंड आई मीट यू टुमोरो एट द सेम टाइम बिटवीन 4:30 to 5 एंड टुमोरो वील बी डिस्कसिंग द मस्ट नो इमेजेस इन पीडियाट्रिक डर्मेटोलॉजी ओके। ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ सिफिलिस, येस ट्रिपल हेलिक्स, आफ्टर ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ सिफिलिस द हेयर विल ग्रो बैक ओके। दिस इज नॉट अ कॉज फॉर स्कारिंग एलोपेशिया ओके। ट्रिपल हेलिक्स, आई होप दैट्स क्लियर ओके। थैंक यू अमित, थैंक यू न्यू कंसेप्ट, सी यू टुमारो सेम टाइम 4:30, बाय।